Hey everyone, PC games nowadays are massive. Baldur's Gate 3 is a 122GB download, for example. The problem with this is that if your internet connection is 20 megabits per second, it'll take over 13 hours to download it. Yikes. That's why more and more PC gamers are leaving their PCs on overnight to download these massive bloated games. But sometimes they make a fatal mistake. Well, not really fatal, but you know, they put their computers into sleep mode. Now, this would actually seem to make sense, because Windows says that with the sleep mode enabled, the PC stays on but uses low power. Apps stay open, blah 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 blah. That implies the game downloads will keep running overnight, right? Nope. Sorry. Putting your PC in sleep mode will effectively freeze everything on your PC, including Steam, Ubisoft Connect, Epic Games, or whatever program you're using to download games. It also pretty much stops the internet connection, too. That's how Windows achieves the low power that it talks about. So this video is basically a PSA to say that if you want to download your games overnight, you should not put your computer into sleep or hibernate mode. If you're concerned about energy use, then what you should do instead is turn off your PC monitor or set your laptop screen to be off, but keep your laptop running. And you can do this by turning the screen off within the power settings within Windows, but setting the sleep mode to never. Doing this will immediately save power because an LCD or OLED screen does consume a decent amount of power. You should also close down any programs that you don't need, especially if you've got a browser open with hundreds of tabs. To be honest, you could just have Steam or whatever open with everything else closed down. In fact, I tried exactly this on my PC and I tracked the energy use. With three videos playing in a browser and a few programs running, my power usage was around 300 watts. I then closed everything off and also turned the monitor off, and power usage fell to just 70 watts. So this is a pretty big energy saving, meaning that I could then download my games overnight without worrying about wasting power. Running a 70 watt PC overnight for 8 hours will cost around 16 pence in total, using the UK's ultra high energy rates. It'll actually be a bit cheaper in some other countries too. But what if you or your parents are still concerned about leaving your PC running overnight? Well, I'd probably say not to worry, to be honest. There's certainly no harm in running computers overnight or even 24/7. I know many people who only turn them off when Windows updates force it on them, to be honest. You won't damage your computer's components by leaving it running overnight. Having said that, let's say there's a reason that I can't think of why you really need to turn your computer off when the game download is done. Well, luckily, there's a useful tool on GitHub called Steam Auto Shutdown, although this works for any program, not just Steam. You download it and install it as normal, and you can then enable Auto Shutdown. What this does is monitor your internet connection's download rate, and if it drops down too low, it assumes that your game has finished downloading, and it then shuts down your PC. Nice. You can configure this in the settings menu too, so you could safeguard against little internet blips, for example, and maybe say to only shut down after 1 minute of inactivity. I would also lower the download rate a bit, but your mileage may vary. This is actually a really useful tool, and if you are concerned about downloading games overnight, this is a really awesome solution and compromise, and it's entirely free too. And that wraps up today's quick video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. This tells the YouTube algorithm that more people should see this video. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.